From the goals to the plans to the rivals and more, join me as we ask the question of whether SpaceX can send their Starship to the moon. When you look at space, there are a lot of things out there that we as humans want to reach. And the first thing that we truly reached and could grasp was the moon itself. On July 20th, 1969, after many years of trials, tribulations, setbacks, delays, fears, and more, we sent three men into space, and two of them landed on the moon. The third stayed in the craft, just for the record. Someone had to watch their ride. It was a triumphant moment in human history, but it was also something that afterwards lost its luster in terms of repeating the feat. We did go back to the moon multiple times, but each time it got more and more costly and more questioned, until eventually the Apollo program, which was the program to get people to the moon, was outright canceled. Only recently did things start to look better for the program, as both NASA and Elon Musk via SpaceX decided to go and inspire the human race to try and get back to the moon in a good amount of time. In fact, it could be that we get to the moon again very soon, even before we reach the long-awaited Mars, or at least that's what Elon Musk thinks. Well, this is going to sound pretty crazy, but I think we could land on the moon in less than 2 years, Musk told Time. Certainly with an uncrewed vehicle, I believe we could land on the moon in 2 years. So then maybe within a year or two of that, we could be sending a crew, I would say 4 years at the outside. In other words, Musk is saying his conservative estimate for sending people back to the moon aboard a SpaceX vehicle is 2023, the year before NASA hopes to send a crew, including the first female astronaut to visit the moon, as part of its new Artemis program. You might think that this is a friendly competition thing going on, but it's a little more complicated than that. You see, Elon Musk started SpaceX with others to try and restore humanity's faith in reaching out to the stars. And it's worked. But more importantly than that, he wanted to make an independent space company that didn't rely on government funding like NASA, and thus be able to make spaceships, satellites, and more at a much cheaper cost, which again he succeeded in. This has actually put NASA and SpaceX on great terms. And the two are working together in various ways, including sending certain SpaceX ships up to the International Space Station and working together on plans to get humanity to Mars. However, NASA has noted recently that they desire to go to the moon on their own craft, which of course prompted a response from Elon. If it were to take longer to convince NASA and the authorities that we can do it versus just doing it, then we might just do it. It may literally be easier to just land Starship on the moon than try to convince NASA that we can. And that right there is one of the cruxes of Elon Musk's belief in his team and his spaceships. If he thinks he can do something, he'll push to do it. And he's been more right than wrong in recent months and years with his programs. His communication satellite system Starlink has started launching and is getting closer to its first minor test in North America. The various starships that he's making is getting more and more tests and so on and so forth. That being said, we all know that Elon Musk can talk more than he can produce at times. A lot of his spaceships in recent months have had issues, including one of his ships trying to launch and creating a massive fireball instead. The ship was fine, and it was revealed that a leak in a system caused a fireball, but still it delayed future plans by a significant margin. Which is why many aren't exactly believing that Elon Musk is going to reach the moon in the next few years, because of the uncertainty of space travel and all the dangers that can go along with it. But that doesn't mean that no one may be able to reach the moon in the next few years. Before we dive more into what we mean by that, be sure to like or dislike the video. That way we have a feedback to improve our work, and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Jeff Bezos is the founder of Amazon. You know, the major website where you likely have bought more things than you care to admit? And throughout his life, he's had a fascination with space. So much so that it was him who found the Apollo 11 engines that were jettisoned during the launch of the legendary mission. But unlike many, he's not looking to Mars, unlike NASA and SpaceX, among others. He feels that humanity has a lot to get from the moon itself, Not to mention he feels it'd be better and cheaper to try and launch a colony mission there versus one to Mars. And technically, he is right. The problem for a moon colony mission has always been whether we could work with the limited survival resources there. But for Bezos and others, they're looking at the more financial reasonings to go there. Because what the moon lacks in atmosphere and water, it makes up for in cobalt, gold, helium, iron, palladium, platinum, tungsten, and other resources. However, just because he thinks the moon is better doesn't mean it's any easier to get there. Except that he has a way to possibly do it better, cheaper, and of course put him and Amazon on the map once again in a big way. He calls it Blue Origin. What is Blue Origin? Well, that would be Jeff Bezos' personal space company, not unlike what Elon Musk has with SpaceX. And what he is working on is a reusable engine that wouldn't just send astronauts to the moon, but also send tourists into space. All of which would help make Bezos billions of dollars in contracts from various space agencies, since his rockets are currently very advanced. Plus, having reusable rockets saves time from having to build individual ones for each mission, which obviously can be very costly as well. Has he actually proven that his rockets work? Yes, actually he has. He has two rockets that he has both in the works and is also testing. One of them is the 59-foot New Shepard model. This is the one that he aims to use to put people into space. In May of 2019, he launched and landed one of those powerful rockets without any issue. Early speculation states that he could go and put people into space very soon, possibly even during 2020 should things work out. However, he's not stopping there. He's also working on a model known as New Glenn, which is 310 feet tall and can go much farther than the New Shepard model. If this was to be launched, it would be the biggest space vehicle ever put into space. The International Space Station doesn't count, for the record. Should it work, it could be the definitive vehicle to take man back to the moon, and the vehicle that we start putting our hopes of moon colonization on. It's still early to say it'll go that far, but Bezos is most definitely banking on that. If you think that Bezos is stopping with two different kinds of rockets that could land men on the moon, you clearly don't understand just how determined this man is to get into the space race in his own way. During a presentation in Washington, D.C., he went into detail on some of the things that Blue Origin is working on to help get men back to the moon. One of those things was a new lunar lander that could help get materials from the spaceships they make to the surface without much difficulty. So why does that matter? Simple. NASA is wanting to get back to the moon by 2024. And so if Bezos is able to make his lander, say by 2021, prove it could work on the moon and more, that saves NASA a ton of time and money trying to make their own to take care of their astronauts. As they say, many hands make light work, and Bezos is going all out to try and make sure that enough work is done so they can launch with his stuff as soon as possible. This is the kind of collaboration that Elon Musk is actually trying to push for. Why have all of these space agencies working against each other in a race to places when we can take bits of technology from each and cover the distance in half the time? That's honestly what's going on with the Mars missions right now in many ways. So imagine what could happen if Musk, Bezos, and NASA worked together on the moon mission. Which of course begs the question of, what would it take to make a colony on the moon in some capacity, right? Let's start with the basics. We would need to get supplies to the moon for construction. We kind of have that taken care of via the shuttles, engines, and more. Not to mention Elon Musk is working on space cranes right now that can help with construction on other planets. No, seriously, he's working on that. But that's just the first hurdle of the lot. Once we get the materials on the moon, we need to start building everything, which as people on the International Space Station will tell you, is not easy. If you lose a tool, you can't just pick it up. Gravity is 6 times lighter on the moon than on Earth, so that'll put a stress on construction. This says nothing of the scale of the production itself. We'd need to make sure it was big enough to fill a whole colony worth of people. That means having it stand a great height, as well as a great width and length. Obviously, it wouldn't need to fit a whole city for the first one, but that would be the goal eventually. even a town of a colony with like 100 people will need to be big enough to fit that amount of people comfortably. That's not easy. Is it doable? Sure, why not? But it's about time, effort, money, and more, and that adds up in the long term. Speaking of long term, to survive on the moon long term, we'd need a power source. It'd need to be some kind of generator, maybe one powered by solar energy. After all, we couldn't possibly do gas or oil, because that would not only be limiting. If something went wrong, it'd be hard to fix. Or if there is a shortage of oil or gas, we'd be screwed. There's also the problem of food and water. Neither of those happen on the moon naturally. In the case of water, the amount is so small that it's said that 1 ton of moon dirt would have 32 ounces of water at most. So humanity would need to find a way to make it so we can have water and food consistently, likely by recycling what we have to make water, which is what astronauts do in space, and growing food ourselves somehow. And at this point, you might be thinking, with all of the risks and the dangers, with all the testing and hoping that everything will work, why do we want to go to the moon again? Simple, because we can, and because we need to, in all the ways that matter. Right now, the Earth is in a place where we could use some inspiration and some hope, especially with a certain epidemic going on. But more than that, we need to expand to other worlds. That's why people like Musk and the teams at NASA are trying to get us to Mars. But as Bezos has noted time and time again, the moon is just as valuable a resource if we do it right. And that's why we need to get there. Not only because it'd be easier to colonize the moon than Mars, but because having any kind of colony on any place outside of Earth is a huge achievement for mankind. Sure, it won't have the immediate benefits as we're trying to construct everything, but if we play it the right way, make things work and more, we can go and help get ourselves to a place where people can honestly live on the moon. And isn't that worth it? Many people believe that it is. And that's one of the biggest things here. We're trying to inspire belief again. Belief in what we can do. Belief in what the human race can achieve if we push hard enough. Love him or hate him, Elon Musk has belief. And he's pushing things hard and trying to get these perceived crazy things because he knows that if he accomplishes them, he's going to inspire people. And that's what Elon Musk loves to do, inspire. Now, who's going to get to the moon first? Who knows? And honestly, who cares? It shouldn't be a race. It should be that we get there and we advance ourselves when we get there. We have a chance to get back to the place that we dreamed about for so long and then took for granted. It's time to fix that mistake and turn the moon into our next proving ground for life beyond Earth. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of these missions to the moon that are in the works right now? Who do you think will get there first? Elon, Bezos, or NASA? Do you hope that we'll get a moon colony one day? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to like or dislike the video, and I'll see you next time.